Acute myeloid leukemia, while rare overall, is one of the most common types of leukemia, and it's primarily found in older adults with an average age of 67 years old when they're diagnosed. And researchers agree there's a real need to expand treatment options that are less toxic for this high-risk group. For patients diagnosed with acute myeloid leukemia, or AML, traditional chemotherapy treatment options, while effective and life-saving, can't be endured by many of the elderly patients.
And that involves 7 consecutive days of treatment that's so harsh that the patients need to be in hospital the whole time, not only for the treatment, but also for the 3 weeks or so of recovery that follows the completion of that week of therapy.
In a study published in the journal Blood, Dana-Farber Cancer Institute's Dr. Anthony Letai explains a drug, Venetoclax, combined with another drug, azacytidine, might offer an effective treatment option that will be easier to tolerate. The FDA recently granted accelerated approval for Venetoclax for such AML patients. Previously, it was FDA approved for chronic lymphocytic leukemia, or CLL.
That was a landmark event for the field of apoptosis that I work in.
Apoptosis is like a suicide path for cells. For years, researchers at Dana-Farber have known a protein called BCL2 fights apoptosis, keeping the cancer cells alive. Venetoclax interferes with that protein in CLL, and Dr. Letai says this research shows it's promising. It can do the same for AML with less toxic side effects.
It certainly is a hopeful finding, this type of test, that compared to historical controls, this combination seems to do much better.
Dr. Letai credits a huge collaboration to make this research possible, and he says researchers look forward to the results from a phase 3 study to confirm these findings. For Dana-Farber News, I'm Victoria Warren.